The future potential of demand response is immense to be a key enabler of getting a lot of wind and solar into electricity grids fast. But clean energy wasn't the original motivation for demand response. Early adopters were more motivated by a desire to avoid the need to overbuild traditional generation like gas power plants and transmission line upgrades to deal with occasional large spikes in demand on the grid. So they instead focused on reducing demand during times when the grid was most stressed. In some US states, it now addresses over 10% of peak electricity demand. And over in New Zealand, they adopted demand response in 2007, and it now fulfills more than 16% of its peak demand through these programs. These early programs can mostly be described as central command and control. In this model, a central authority, like a utility company, remotely controls appliances and systems to balance the load. They might lower your thermostat by a couple of degrees or suspend charging of your EV during peak times, or negotiate with an aluminium smelter to lower output for a while. This method ensures a coordinated and reliable response. A frequent critique of these programs is the discomfort of giving up control over your energy usage to the government or the utility. Can you trust them to manage that power responsibly? Will you end up overheating in the summer or get in your car only to find that its battery has been drained by demand response?